some ASMR. I apologize for not uploading last week. Life has just been getting kinda busy. I feel it will only get busier, but I will do my best to upload more consistently. And I'm also working on getting a better mic so I can make some better quality videos with some ear-to-ear whispers and other triggers as well. For today, however, with Halloween right around the corner, I've got some spooky stories for y'all. So, lay down, get nice and cozy, and enjoy some ASMR. So, I found this website with some short stories. The website is called Scoop Whoop, and there's quite a few different types of stories, but like I mentioned, we'll be doing some spooky ones. So, the first one is called This New Old House, and it's by Bat Out of Hell 821. We bought an old house, my boyfriend and I. He's in charge of the new construction, converting the kitchen into a master bedroom, for instance, while I'm on wallpaper removal duty. The previous owner papered every wall and ceiling. Removing it is brutal, but oddly satisfying. The best feeling is getting a long peel, similar to your skin when you're peeling from a sunburn. I don't know about you, but I kinda make a game of peeling on the hunt for the longest piece before it rips. Under a corner section of paper in every room is a person's name and a date. Curiosity got the best of me one night when I googled one of the names and discovered the person was actually a missing person. The missing date matching the date under the wallpaper. The next day, I made a list of all the names and dates. Sure enough, each name was for a missing person with dates to match. We notified the police, who naturally sent out the crime scene team. And I overheard one tech say, "Yup, it's human." "Human? What's human?" "Ma'am, where is the material you removed from the walls already?" "This isn't wallpaper you were removing." Yeah, I knew it was gonna be something like that once they said human. That's crazy. I also don't really know about the peeling from a sunburn. I don't think I've ever actually had one. Or I did, but it was just too long ago to remember. This next one is called Guardians by Dark Alligator. He awoke to the huge insect-like creatures looming over his bed and screamed his lungs out. They hastily left the room, and he stayed up all night, shaking, wondering if it had been a dream. The next morning, there was a tap on the door. Gathering his courage, he opened it to see one of them gently place a plate filled with fried breakfast on the floor, then retreat to a safe distance. Bewildered, he accepted the gift. The creatures chittered excitedly. This happened every day for weeks. At first, he was worried they were fattening him up. But after a particularly greasy breakfast left him clutching his chest from heartburn, they were replaced with fresh fruit, as well as cooking. They poured hot, steamy baths for him, and even tucked him in when he went to bed. It was bizarre. One night, he awoke to gunshots and screaming. He raced downstairs to find a decapitated burglar being devoured by the insects. He was sickened, but disposed of the remains as best he could. He knew they had just been protecting him. One morning, the creatures wouldn't let him leave his room. He lay down, confused, but trusting, as they ushered him back into bed. Whatever their motives, they weren't going to hurt him. But hours later, a burning pain spread throughout his body. It felt like his stomach was filled with razor wire. The insects chittered as he spasmed and moaned. It was only when he felt a terrible squirming feeling beneath his skin that he realized the insects insects hadn't been protecting him. They had been protecting their young. I don't know why that reminds me of the one scene from The Mummy where, like, there was scarabs under this one guy's skin. That's all I remember for that part. I was a bit young when I saw that. But this was also reminding me of the Grim Adventures of Billy and Mandy, where Billy sits on an egg and it hatches into a spider. And in the cutest little voices, like, "Daddy." But Billy, he doesn't like spiders, so he's always trying to kill it. And then it grows up and is, like, able to speak, and it makes him pancakes. I don't know how he learned how to make pancakes. Probably the same way these insects learn how to cook food. This next one is called "They Got the Definition Wrong." And I'm not entirely sure how to pronounce the name. I think it's pronounced Loyu. It's spelled L-L-O-I-U. And let's see. It has been said that the definition of insanity is doing the same thing over and over, and expecting different results. I understand the statement behind the saying, but it's wrong. I entered the building on a bet. I was strapped for cash and didn't buy into the old legends of the hotel to begin with. So, $50 was more than enough to get me to do it. It was simple. Just reach the top floor, the 45th floor. Shine my flashlight from a window. The hotel was old and broken, including the elevator. So that meant hiking up the stairs. So up I went. As I reached each platform, I noted the old brass plaques displaying the floor numbers. 15, 16, 17, 18. I felt a little tired as I crept higher, but so far, no ghosts, no cannibals, no demons. Piece of cake. I can't tell you how happy I was as I entered that last stretch of numbers. I joyfully counted aloud at each platform. 40, 41, 42, 43, 44, 44. I stopped and looked back down the stairs. I must have miscounted. So I continued up. 44. One more flight. 44. and then down 10 flights. 44. 15 flights. 44. And so, it's been for as long as I can remember. So really, insanity isn't doing something repeatedly and expecting different results. It's knowing that the results will never, ever change. That each door leads to the same staircase, to the same number. It's realizing you no longer fall asleep. It's not knowing whether you've been running for days or weeks or years. It's when the sobbing slowly turns into laughter. That is pretty crazy. That could make someone go insane. Going up those stairs, never reaching the destination. And it was in the dark too. And I wouldn't have done that for 50. I would have said like 100 for each flight. Although, he is still technically doing the definition. He's going up the stairs over and over. I guess expecting a different result. Because you're expecting to get to a new floor. I don't know. And so, dear listeners, we come down to the last one. And it is called, My Daughter Learned to Count by Real Science. 87. My daughter woke me around 11:50 last night. My wife and I had picked up her from her friend Sally's birthday party, brought her home, and put her to bed. My wife went into the bedroom to read while I fell asleep watching the Braves game. Daddy, she whispered, tucking my shirt sleeve. Guess how old I'm going to be next month. I don't know, beauty. I said, as I slipped on my glasses. How old? She smiled and held up four fingers. It is 7:30 now. My wife and I have been up with her for almost 8 hours. She still refuses to tell us where she got them. Got what? I don't. Oh, I get it. She was holding up not her fingers, but fingers. That's scary. Well, that was the last story, but I'll share a bonus story. This one is a true story. In fact, this happened to me on this day, I'd say about 10 years ago. I was giving out candies for trick-or-treaters. There was this one trick-or-treater, and they had like all black they almost looked formal. But they had like a cape, and it was like red on the inside. And they wore this strange, almost cartoony kind of mask. But the mask looked kind of like my brother's godfather. I'm not really sure what's about the mask made me think of him. But anyways, the kid approached the door. I had it open while I was eating so I could keep an eye out. And when he approached, this kid was dragging their foot. And they didn't respond to me when I said I was coming. They didn't say trick or treat. They didn't say a single thing. I tried to get them to speak, complimenting them on their costume, trying to make some sort of small talk, but no response. And they didn't even reach for the candy. They just stared at me. So I took a few candy bars in my hand and handed it to the kid. They didn't even take their hand out from under their cape, just put their hand while holding the cape over mine. I thought like I was gonna feel the hand and it was gonna feel like scaly or leathery or something. It's gonna be like sharp claws and just drag me in and into the cape and eat me. I was like, what the heck is with this kid? Why is he being so creepy? And then he took the candy and just walked away, dragging their foot. And they stopped, turned back to look at me, and then just walked away again. And that was like the scariest Halloween experience I have ever had. It was just like unsettling. But anyways, I hope that you guys had or have had, for those who may celebrate early, a happy Halloween. And good night.